Alright guys, welcome to Game 3. This is Purge casting the finals of the Rokkat Gosu Cup number 4. EXE is currently up 2-0 and it's a best of 5, so if they win the next game, it is over for MUFC. We're on a more fair host here, and once again, man, EXE is still banning the Enchantress Lone Druid. Very surprising. They played a very consistent game so far, just eking out a little bit more win and better lanes, in my opinion. The last game they laned the Lifestealer with the Ancient Apparition, and that worked extremely well against the mid lane Pugna, despite Pugna's good play. And eventually it just was too much. He pretty much got free farm and got kills as well in that lane, and it worked out really, really good for EXE. And they did very well in the other lanes as well, and turned that into some very good team fights in the mid game. So, very good win for EXE there. Finally, game three here. This could end the entire tournament, guys. The tournament will be over after this set. Finally, the Rokkat Ghost Cup number 4 with a $2,500 prize pool. And first round bans, Enchant Lone Druid Bat, and then we see an Omni-Knight, Shadow Demon, and a Lycan. Now, EXE did already use a Lycan and an Omni-Knight very effectively to win games, so that's part of the reason I'm expecting MUFC here to ban those heroes. But could still go a lot of different ways. There's a lot of time left. And first pick is going to be Ancient Apparition of EXE. So once again, they're going to use the AA. We'll see if they dual, single, or solo, or tri-lane him. He does give you a lot of options. So he's one of those really nice heroes for that reason. In terms of an Imba pick, at least in a lot of ways, heroes that decide that he is Imba. And I think he is very good. I do remember some Malaysian teams, or I think it's primarily Malaysian teams, decided that they said that he's not very popular. But I think in a lot of ways, AA has been proven to be extremely effective. His ulti is really annoying. Can't heal, you can shatter. But most importantly, it's global. So with good coordination, and some teams are better than this than others, but with a really good coordination, you can basically just throw an AA ulti to a different lane. And that's like another nuke that you don't necessarily see coming. And if he's aiming properly, you know, that gets you kills. So that would be really cool to see more stuff like that. Fast picks, I missed the Vengeful Spirit, the Chen. Once again, a Chen out of MUFC. We see a Puck and a Windrunner, which is exactly so far the same. And finally going to see an Obsidian Destroyer by MUFC. They pick him up. There was a little bit of chat from this before. I believe it was one of the EXE players a little worried about that OD, but apparently MUFC likes to play that hero. I like the hero a lot as well. And we'll see what EXE goes for now. They could definitely ban some more support heroes. Probably going to be some solos, more likely than not. Maybe Puck and Windrunner are the easiest long lane solos, in my opinion, other than maybe Clockwork, but we'll see if there's a Clockwork pick. I think Clockwork is not a bad hero by any means against both Windrunner, Ancient Apparition, Puck not necessarily, obviously, because he can get out of the cogs, but those other two heroes, pre-force staff, it's going to be a little bit of an issue for them. So they're going to ban an Earthshaker, though. That's going to be the support hero that they're banning out, and I think that's really wise, because they could always do a Venge, Earthshaker, someone else trialing. Venge isn't super far ranged, only 400 range, so as a result he's not the best harasser. But he is ranged, and that can cause some good solutions. So MUFC two bans left, Broodmother is still in the pool. We'll see if we see a Broodmother ban. I'd be a little surprised if MUFC had to ban Broodmother, because EXE already has quite a few solos once again. But it's going to be an Anti-Mage ban. I think that's pretty smart. Anti-Mage, I mean, some people say that Anti-Mage hard counters OD, but I don't completely agree with that for the reasons of this. I mean, sure, OD usually has an extremely full mana pool, so Anti-Mage can't ulti him effectively, but that's pretty much it. And OD has period damage orbs. Those are the two reasons, basically, why, in a way, OD is a counter to Anti-Mage. But that's literally about it. OD's ulti does no damage, essentially, because it's magic damage. It's resisted by Anti-Mage. His orb, they go through the magic resistance. That's cool and all, but basically every time Anti-Mage hits OD, OD is going to have mana, which means every time that OD is hit by Anti-Mage, Anti-Mage gets like a bonus 64 damage, which is a crap load of damage. And quick point out here, still no Invokers this whole time. Then this is the first time he's gotten banned, I think. So yeah, Anti-Mage is always going to do bonus damage. OD's armor isn't ridiculously high. It's pretty good, but it's not ridiculously high. And, you know, like, that bonus damage really makes a difference. If you really want to shut down a Anti-Mage, you should probably play a Spectre and get equal farm. That's probably the best way. Or just get a lot of disables and do heavy ganking, basically. Or deny him farm. You know, those are your better options. So I think Anti-Mage, banning an Anti-Mage against an OD is not necessarily... I mean, Anti-Mage is the best carry and you can farm really fast, but I don't think... That was a very long explanation of why I think Anti-Mage is not a wonderful counter to, or OD isn't a wonderful counter to Anti-Mage. Alright, so now that we did see a Lich ban, MEFC very wisely banning Lich there. As a result, like I said, shutting down the enemy carries, Dark Ritual is a bitch, especially if you're playing hard carry. So they ban the Lich, and as a result, Broodmother does slip through, and EXE is able to pick him up. So now they're going to have to fit their lanes in kind of a weird situation, because they were kind of pigeonholed into picking that Broodmother. I mean, Broodmother's a really good hero, but they do have a lot of solos already, so AA is surely going to have to play a support role. Broodmother will be probably pretty much guaranteed solo in a lane, Puck pretty much has to solo lane, and if they pick up a jungler here, their problems will be slightly lessened, but they are going to have to run into the fact that there's a Chen in the game, so if they do pick up a jungler, I mean, who's left? And even still, any jungler is always going to be threatened by a hero like Chen. Now, I think Chen is maybe not the best counter jungler. I think Enchantress is probably a little bit better, but Chen can get it done as well. He's gonna always have that creep. He can steal your creep every 30 seconds, etc. And I think Enchantress is probably a little bit better for counter jungling because you can kind of change his roles. Chen needs creeps basically, and if he doesn't have a creep, he's a ranged auto attacker with a shitty nuke or a shitty disable at the low levels at least. I'm not saying Test of Faith or Penitence are bad. Those are both really good abilities, but they're not very good at level 2, you know. Alright, one pick here for EXE. One to go. Probably going to be a support hero or a jungler. That's what I'm expecting. And as a result, they may end up tri-laning. Or something else. And oh, wow. MUFC picks up a Broodmother. Or, I'm sorry, a Sand King. That's going to be a hard counter to MUFC's Broodmother. So we'll see if they lane them properly. We may end up seeing Broodmother maybe go bottom lane, I think. I think we're going to see Broodm go. But OD is probably going to be either mid or top. Almost for sure. Pretty much guaranteed. Zane King needs to try to predict Broodmother, though. So, depending on where Broodmother goes, we'll see how effectively this ends up working out. This could be the final game you guys are asking in chat. Yeah, this is game 3 of the best 5 series. So, if EXE pulls out the win, they're up 2-0. If they pull out the win, that's it. And they're going to pick Benenigma, so they will go for a jungling hero to round out their lineup here. And that's going to also give them some viability in terms of creep denying as well. We'll see if he jungles or actually lanes. I expect him to jungle, to be honest. Okay, one more pick left from MUFC. I said wrong. What did I say wrong, Cookie? It's EXE's Brood. I meant that. I may have said it's MUFC's Brood, but I meant it's EXE's Brood. Please excuse me. So they did pick up Enigma. One more pick to go. MUFC trying to figure out who they want. They probably are going to need... I feel like their solos aren't very extremely strong. I mean, Sand King is really good against Brood. That's a good solo. OD can solo mid pretty effectively, pretty darn effectively. But top lane is basically going to be somebody plus Vengeful Spirit with a Chen. Or it's going to be their bot lane, which would be Chen. Or it looks like it's going to be Lion soloing with Avenge jungling on a Chen. I really like that pick. I think a Lion is just so good in so many different situations. So I personally think I like MUFC's picks a little bit better compared to EXE's. They kind of got forced into picking up the Brood because Brood's too good to pick up and they couldn't let the enemy team get him. So, alright, so let's go over EXE, guys. They're up 2-0. If they win this game, that is it for the Rogue Cat Gosu Cup. And come to below me. It's basically below me is Brood playing the Broodmother. We have Victory on the Fairy Dragon playing Puck again. I think this is his third game in a row playing Puck. The EDE is going to be playing Ancient Apparition. We have the Nino is going to be on Enigma. And finally, who did I miss? Hexor is going to be playing the Windrunner. Now the Dire team, or the Scourge team, MUFC, we have Holy Knight being played by Ling, Sharky is on the OD, KYXY playing Sand King, Annette is on the Vengeful Spirit, and finally 2Fing Good is playing the Lion. So they're looking to spot out some heroes. They do have a smoke up. Will they spot somebody? I think they're going to spot the Puck. Are they going to come back? OD notices him, but Puck immediately booking it. And look at this, pretty sloppy reaction time from MUFC. They could have gotten this kill, possibly. Not a ton of disable, though. I mean, alright, they had 3 stuns. That would have been enough. If maybe Venge leads off or a Banish from OD or something. And look at that armor, man. 5 plus 2.7 with that arcane. Our fast Basilius here. And it looks like they have revealed that Broodmother's top. So I think SK is going to swing all the way top. Just hold against Broodmother. Picking up the fast out shield like this as well. Going to keep him more alive against Spiderlings. And OD in the mid lane currently. With stat items. Is he going for a bottle or something? He only has one Tango. It's very, very generally inadequate. And it looks like it will be Venge. And yeah, Lion soloing the bot lane with support from Venge and a jungling chen, so that's gonna be pretty cool stuff. It's gonna be a little hard to kill the fairy dragon, but if they get some disables off from the Lion, chain disables is gonna produce a dead puck basically. Now, Ancient Apparition with the Invis Rune, he's on the high ground, and surprisingly, Enigma is actually gonna be jungling in the Scourge jungle. And I think this is really smart basically, because they knew that Chen was probably gonna go bottom. They're gonna basically guaranteed put Sand King where Broodmother is, and as a result, they get a little bit more options. Are they going to get the... Yeah, taking a decent amount of damage. 200 damage there done to the Sand King. He's going to have to eat his first Tango. And Puck finally skilling Illusory Orb. There's the Banish on the Windrun. It's going to reduce his attack damage and his mana pool, so he's going to have to be kind of careful. A Basilius in this case ends up working really, really well. It's kind of like switching your treads to agility before you use a bottle. So if you have like agility treads and a Ring of Basilius, you can actually get pretty... The banishment can actually benefit you. It's kind of funny. You have to wait till like the banishment runs out. Your int goes back up after you heal up your Ring of Basilius. It's cool stuff. Ancient Apparition once again supporting the SK. So as a result, his supposed to be solo lane is not working out. And this is something really cool that EXE is doing here. Almost any game you ever see a Broodmother played, he's solo, period. He's going to be a solo hero. It's like, okay, solo Brood, because he can solo. But all of a sudden, if you lane him against a Sand King, Sand King's like, oh, I can be a solo Brood, no problem. And then they just rotate a single support hero up. It's going to be an Ancient Apparition. He's level 1. He's looking to do pulls here. But all of a sudden, wow, Ancient Apparition going to jack the pull. Wow, man, he is doing such a good job. The EDE, man, just really shutting down the Sand King here. Just throwing the Ancient Apparition into the lineup means Brood is once again solo. Ancient Apparition doesn't get any EXP, but not a huge deal because he is a support hero and their other solos are pretty survivable. And all of a sudden, Brood's going to get a pretty easy lane here. Cold Feet once again going down, spending that mana, and Sand King down to 200 HP. He did have that Stout Shield to prevent a lot of damage here, but it's really making the difference. I really, really like EXE. They play such a smart game. The lanes are so important, and all of a sudden, it comes down to a normal situation. Windrunner against OD, it's pretty good for Windrunner. Puck is survivable on the solo lane. Lion's getting solo EXP, which is dangerous because Lion is a good hero. And Chen and Venge are also getting good EXP jungle farm. But, I mean, I really like what EXE is doing. I think this is extremely smart. And AA, once again, in position to deny the CS. And the best part is, AA doesn't have any experience here. But look at Sand King. Sand King is like one CS higher than Ancient Apparition is. And he's going to jack this pull again. Oh, he messes it up this time, unfortunately. Did not get the creeps to aggro to himself, so... Finally going to get some solo EXP. Wow, Fairy Dragon almost dying here on the bot lane. Lion actually spending the mana. And Vengeful Spirit holding it, looking like they use their spells as well. So Puck will survive. Power Shot not quite as effective as Windrunner was hoping it would be. And Bottle also very good against OD. Anytime he banishes you, lowers your intelligence, and then you bottle up, and then just wait until the intelligence comes back, and you are good to go, man. And we will probably see that. He's got about 290. And we'll watch his int go up. Popping some GG branches there. Okay, transferring a magic wand. Another pull by the Sand King. He actually got a double pull off this time. I think it's the same pull. And will they be able to jack the CS? It's hard to say. Broodmother now just going to take out these neutrals. He has a lot of spiders, so it's understandable. He can actually do this pretty effectively, and the tower taking good damage as well. Ancient Apparition finally up to level 2 now, and Sand King has to play completely sissy. Almost at level 2, but not quite there. And here comes some items. It's going to be a transfer. I missed first blood on the bot lane. It's going to be Puck finally going down. Just so much action happening here. Ancient Apparition forces the Sand King back once again. Puck is the first to die, but honestly, against these three heroes, if Puck dies at 4 minutes for the first time, I think that's pretty good. It's not a huge loss for EXE. It's going to happen eventually is probably the way to look at it. And will Windrunner be able to deny this? I had to hit it a lot of times, but... Yeah, and Enigma now on the top lane. He's got a Soul Ring finish. He's been in the jungle this whole time, up to level 5. And as a result, we're going to lose the top tower. Sand King coming in for a level 1 gank. His disable is so shitty, though. He can't do anything. Like, look at this. Oh my god, he doesn't even have stun. He has Caustic Finale level 1 because he thought he was laning against a Broodmother. He literally had no survivability top. No wonder he got so screwed. He's probably going to pick up Sandstorm here, which means he can at least stand within EXP range unless there's dust. But wow, no wonder he was getting so shut down. Picked up that Caustic Finale level 1. Man, really, really rough for MUFC here. KYXY has got to be upset about that. Maybe should have waited to skill his ability before he saw that Ancient Apparition was going to be riding him the whole time. Benjin Chen going for another gank, possibly Centaur Khan in position. Puck is up to level 5. If Lion can disable this, they may be able to get the scent in for the disable. But nope, Centaur will be spotted. Puck will be fine for now, and they're going to continue the push. I really like this once again. Can we talk about how cool the Enigma is on this lane as well? It's like a Broodmother with Enigma support. Those are both pushing heroes. So that's two pushing heroes supported by an Ancient Apparition. Just like really interesting laning. Smart stuff that EXE keeps doing. And this is why they're winning their games, man. Because they do really cool smart lanes like this. But here's the smoke gank coming out in the mid lane. Windrunner is significantly easier to gank. And he has been banished. And there comes the gank. He did pop his haste though. There's the first stun. Will he be able to escape? No. The Centaur gets the disable off. And they actually barely pick off Windrunner. Very, very close. If he would have ran this way instead, he may have been able to get out, but the disable from Vengeful Spirit was just enough to get the Centaur stun off, and very, very good gank there. That was extremely well played by MUFC. Going for a gank on the top lane. Now, Lion comes in. He's going to easy pick off the Enigma. Enigma goes down, and Broodmother may change targets. I'm a little surprised he's taking this long to auto-attack on that line. Lion with the treads, though. Do they have dust? I see no dust. They're not going to have any dust. They're not going to be able to gank on the Broodmother. Feeding a lot of spiders, a lot of spider blood here on the ground. Tower's taking damage though, and once again, very nice TP from Lion, absolutely changing the scope of that push. EXE getting a little too aggressive as a result, and will they go after the OD? Not going to ult on him. A little surprised. Oh man, Puck is not level 6 yet. Rough stuff. There's some free farm on the bot lane. All those guys TP to the top lane. Broodmother finally going to escape from outside the tower, and looks like Venge wants to do something about it. He's got no smoke, he's got sentries. Will he drop a sentry? First sentry dropped, he thought Broodmother would be running away. He actually juking this way. Does he have net cooldown? He is so slow off net. If he gets caught, it's nighttime though. I don't think they spotted him. And the spiders are giving constant vision to him. So he's going to be absolutely fine here. There's a shackle shot. It's going on the Vengeful Spirit. Will they disable? There's the stun on Enigma. Power shot will barely hit Obsidian Destroyer. He's in a lot of trouble, but he's going to pop up self. And there's the disable on the spider. This could be it for Broodmother. There's a stun from Lion, and that's it. Broodmother goes down. A little bit of a mistake there. No net. Another power shot puts OD to 74 HP, and really unfortunate for EXE. Is this really a 5-0 swing? Wow, MUFC up 5-0 here. I cannot believe it. They really shut down the Sand King. He's up to level 5, finally getting some EXP, and MUFC playing really smart. They know that if they don't win this game, it is over for them, so they have to play really smart. And the Observer Ward, or sorry, the Sentry Ward is going to spot the puck, but it doesn't matter. Still going to get the nukes off, and yeah, Chen will go down. Who gets the last hit? It's going to be Ancient Apparition sneaking that away. They're going to go on that Centaur, and will they be able to get the CS? I don't think they will, actually. It's okay, they can kill the Wildkin. Oh, that's why the Tornado. Wow, Tornado did a lot of damage there. Alright, they have to kill this OD. He's going for the Mechanism. And once again, guys, Mechanism is not a bad OD item. His mana pool is so huge that spending the mana on the mech is not going to cause any problems. He's a farming hero. He gets intelligence from it, so his ulti gets boosted, and the armor is never going to hurt. Up to level 8 currently. Needs to get his Essence Aura up, though, before he's able to spam that. And he is currently at level 3. Broodmother continuing the top lane up to level 6. He has treads finished. Haste rune picked up by the OD. And Benjin Chen back in the jungle. Chen's surprisingly not very farmed, and they're going to lose a ward. I'm not really sure what the duration of that was. Probably pretty high. Still, I expect. Ancient Apparition helping out with the jungle. He's almost level 5, needs to hit 6, or if he can really contribute to a team fight. And Lion going to continue to get solo CS on the bot lane. Where is Puck, man? Is he mid lane? Windrunner is there. Is Puck, like, in the jungle? He is level 6, but yeah, Puck very underleveled and underfarmed here. He did fight that tri-lane. He did die. He fed first blood to them, but I mean, just kind of an unfortunate situation for him. They're going to spot the Vengeful Spirit, though. He finds some Eidolons. Will they get the nukes off? There's the Puck ulti, and that's going to be it for Vengeful Spirit. There's no way he's going to be able to survive. The Test of Faith, will it save him? He doesn't quite get out in time. Test of Faith, actually, still very low level, probably just level 2. And a nice stun from Lion. Another stun. Just stuns every. Broodmother gets picked off due to the Sentry Ward. Sentry Ward's really lucking out here. And will Spiders and Eidolons be able to kill the line? I think so. Very, very cool stuff. Cold Feet helping out as well. And Centaur looking for his stun. TP Scroll picked up by Sand King. Actually, it's going to be a bottle here. And that's three kills there for EXE finally putting their scores on the board. Point booster now. I'm sorry, phase boots for the Windrunner. He's going to continue CSing against the OD. He cannot give him free farm here. Now Fairy Dragon swinging in the mid lane. Eight wand charges. No bottle. No boots either. Will they try to take out the mid tower? Once again, another haste rune by OD. He's very low mana though. Needs to get his Essence Aura to proc before he can regen. But to do so, he'd have to cast a disable. Here comes the Aulti. Are they going to go? Is it going to be effective? I think they will. There's the dust and very, very good coordination. This is why you guys, this is why you ban the Ancient Apparition, stuff like that. They probably wouldn't have been able to get that kill. I mean, it would have been much harder if they didn't have that Aulti. So Broodmother picks off the easy kill against that Sand King. OD now up to level 9. Still no Essence Aura. A little surprised about that. And not going to look on the tower. Poor man's shield finished on the Broodmother. He wants a little bit more survivability. He has been getting picked off pretty easy. Partially because of the Lion. Disables and nukes from Lion are just so good against picking off heroes. And we actually have 2100 gold on Obsidian Destroyer. A little surprised about this. Power shot will land, but goes through a couple creeps first. It's no big deal there. Odie still no level 4 Essence or a Demon. Lion picking up the stats levels. He has maxed, just about maxed out on Hex. Actually, I don't think he's maxed on Hex yet. Probably should have picked up another Hex level, but opted for stats instead. Probably a little worried about his EXP, or his HP, sorry. Sand King up to level 7, Burrow Strike level 4. Still has not picked up his ulti, I think, because I know he has a Caustic and a Sandstorm. I think he just skipped his ulti. A little peculiar. Not going to get the Shackle shot off. Windrunner wanted that for sure. Still hasn't bought the mech. And is that going to be it? No, it's going to be Fast Force Staff. Fast Force Staff completed on the OD. He's going to go for mech afterwards. He's going for the disable, but he's not going to get it. There's the stun from Venge. Chen coming in, and that's going to be a chain stun. Wow, the ulti from OD did 96 damage, virtually nothing there, and might have drained Windrunner's mana, though. I'm not sure if he had used Windrunner yet. I think he did, actually. And that's going to give him that Force Staff. Force Staff will be completed for the OD. He's going to be a lot more survivable now. Just opting for that Headdress to boost up his stats and regen levels. Give me that Essence Aura, man. Not quite level 10. And there it is. Force Staff plus some TP Scrolls. It's going to hit harder. His mana pool is bigger. It's going to regen a little bit more. And top tower is gone. Broodmother has done his job. Up to 1400 gold. If he does finish that Orchid, though, it's going to be a very, very good counter. Silence on an OD is just really rough to deal with. He's going to have that Force Staff, though. So by the time, I mean, easy to farm a Force Staff before he ends up getting that Orchid. And Chen back in the jungle with the Arcane Boots. Puck trying to get some solo EXP. He's got a bottle. It's on the bot lane, but the wave is pushing. And Sand King, we'll see if he picks up Burrow Strike. I'm sorry, his ulti in a little bit. There's some more disable. Did he trigger his Essence Aura? He's up to level 4 now. Ancient Apparition picking up his Staff of Wizardry, working towards that Arcane. I'm sorry, that Force Staff. And Tower, very. Actually, it is deniable now. 126 HP. Will the OD go for it? It's going to be hard to say. And missing a kill on the bot lane. Wow, once again, Puck gets picked off. Not having a good game. He did a lot of really good job before, and here comes the deny. It's going to land the deny on the tower. And yes, there's the deny. Puck gets picked off by a Sand King and a Chen. Not very expecting. He's actually going to go for Power Treads here. There's the disable. Are they going to be able to pick off the Broodmother? I think they will. Not even, yeah, he does burn the finger. Has to burn the finger there. But they get the kill. Another good gank off. Ventral Spear plus Lion. So good at killing Broodmother before he gets a lot of HP. Enigma still in the jungle. He's got a Vanguard completed. Going for a lot more pushing here than support items. Kind of interesting that they're doing so, but they really do need big survivability against heroes like Lion. You have to get HP levels. Even if you have a mech, it can be a problem because you might get chain stunned before and end up dying. That can be really, really rough. SK in the bottom lane, level 8. Doesn't have a ton of mana here, but will be able to land a stun when Chen comes for the gank. He's hiding in the side shop. Very cool stuff. Where is that Puck at? That underfarmed Puck? Puck, where you at? There? There? He's mid. There he is. He is mid. He's got a bracer, stacking up that HP since he has been dying so much. And Obsidian Destroyer doing a nice job. Almost level 11. It's only going to get stronger from here on out. Let's look at his CS totals. It's 4-9. MUFC finally in an advantage. And are we going to see a gank? No, it's just going to be Spider harassing here. Probably does not. Line does not have his ulti. 80 seconds left. He's got to be pretty careful. He's actually out of mana, so he will have to back off. And Chen getting ready to come in for here. We may see a TP first. Are they going to come? Vengeful Spirit going to wait for Venge, I guess. A ulti coming. They actually want to go on the Sand King. And here comes. The A ulti isn't going to land. It does debuff. They just need one disable. He does Burrow Strike through, and that's going to keep him alive there. All they needed was one Malphite, and I think that would have been it for Sand King. He's going to end up surviving. He actually pops his wand with the A ulti on. Big mistake. And Chen coming through, but wow, actually picks off the Windrunner. There's the black hole, and he gets hexed. Nice TP support from Lion. There's more disable on Enigma. And Puck gets a good ulti off as well, but just a little bit of miscoordination from the EXE here. Are they going to be able to get the Sand King at least? Couple hits, and Puck actually going to overextend himself. May end up dying as a result. He pops his bottle, and yeah, that's it. I think Puck's going to die. Are we going to see the disable? He does get some breaks the line of sight. No stun from Venge. He swaps it instead, and the test of faith. Wow. MUFC doing really good this game. 5-11, up by 6. Definitely outplaying EXE just a little bit, partially as a result of their good lanes. And there's the Hex from Line. Is he going to get the Hex or the Disable? The Impale does land. And wow, they're just doing so good. MUFC playing really good this game finally. 5-12, outplaying EXE for once. Once again, partially because of their lanes in my opinion, but Puck just not having the best game. That's a lot of the problem there. Weren't able to get the Sand King. And then the Chen came by with the Venge and the good TP support from Line as well, and they ended up getting the kill. Getting quite a few kills. Alright, OD with the bracers. He's got power treads as well. It's gonna be Orb and a few dudes. Messing up a little bit. He's level 11. Big mana pool though. He's probably gonna use that bracer to go for a Django, I would expect. Lion trying to get a kill. Almost scoring one, but would have been a little dangerous. Did he have his ulti? He did have his ulti. And a level 11 ulti. He could have killed Windrunner if he got the ulti off, but didn't end up happening. Windrunner is juking well enough that it would have been kind of a pain in the ass for him to go for it. Might have ran into more heroes. And he's going to TP at the top lane. He's up to 1400 gold. He is going for a Blink Dagger. And once he gets that, he's going to be very effective. Broodmother using his spiders in the jungle. Where is he at, actually? We have a gem from Vengeful Spirit. Wow, very, very expensive purchase. Spending that 700 gold to do some dewarding. Enigma going to try to help out. Are we going to see an ulti against the Sand King? He wants to get the disables off, but it is daytime, so it's hard to swing around here. Is he going to notice? He does immediately back up. I don't necessarily think that he got vision. And there's a smoke on Enigma as well. He's going to actually spot out the gank here on Puck. Will Puck back up? Puck may be going aggressive, which is a mistake. If he gets stunned by Sand King, that could be it. He does back up just enough. Ancient Apparition on the way now. He's doing some warding. Will Enigma get spotted? The smoke might get disabled. Those are just neutrals. Those are getting in position though. He's going to spot the Puck out. Need one more TP support. Windrunner is sprinting as fast as she can. And they will go. They're going to find the Chen by himself. There's the Malphite and the Cold Feet. That's it. Chen will get dropped. Will even ulti there. He does not get his ulti off. Going after the Sand King now. Any dust? No dust. He's just still there. And there's the silence. OD coming in. But is he going to get stunned? I think he will. He will get ice blasted. But is the damage enough? Good swap from Vengeful Spirit. And he banishes himself to keep himself alive. Items coming for the Windrunner. It's going to be a mech, actually. He needs to get that item on his person, that's for sure. Pop that Clarity, man. And there's the mech finish. That's going to heal up their team. Will he pop it yet? Still has not quite thought about it. And Vengeful Spirit with that gem, man. Illusions doing a little bit of damage. Kind of a weird team fight. EXE still in a big disadvantage, 6-14. Where's Broodmother been the whole time? Did he get killed? Broodmother just died to Lion. Man, Broodmother having a bad game, man. It is not fun. There's the A-ulti. Trying to predict the OD. He's going to actually banish himself. Cool stuff. And Chen finally respawns and heals. It's going to boost up OD's HP. He's up to 1200 gold. Will he buy more mech components? I expect he will. No, actually, Chen's going to make the mech. I guess he's just going to sit on a Hedros all game. Kind of unusual. It's a 600 gold item, and it does give you 3 HP per second, plus the stats. Maybe he'll make a pipe eventually. Chen's going to make that mech for sure. Maybe just a little bit of mistake. Who knows? Maybe he just likes that item on OD. Make him up to 1k gold. Windrunner at virtually nothing. Just bought that mechanism. And Force Staff finished on Ancient Apparition. So that's going to make a difference when he gets initiated on. Or somebody else. Broodmother is going for Black King Bar. He's continuing to farm here. Chen coming in for another gank. Or at the very least wants to push some towers perhaps. We'll spot the Enigma, but Enigma just profits on some neutrals. He's going to clean up some Eidolons, though. It's always nice to do. Wave of Terror will not spot anybody. A lot of Sentinel heroes in the top jungle. Spiders are going to come in here. There's the A ulti. Are they going to get the Shackle Shot? What is it called, man? Burrow strikes out, but, you know, takes a lot of nukes. Even Puck using his ulti there, a little bit of a waste. But perhaps he didn't realize the Shackle Shot was going to land. They may be able to take a Rax here. If they push really fast and if the Scourge team doesn't react in time. We have no Blink Dagger. I'm sorry, we have no TP on Chen. Venge comes in, though. Gonna pop the Wave of Terror, doing a little bit of damage to the spiders in the wave. Blink Dagger is finished online. He's actually in a little bit of No Man's Land, but I don't believe they know he's there. OD with 2k gold in the bank. What is he going to buy? Probably an ult orb, perhaps? Maybe save for that Mystic Staff. Maybe a BKB, who knows? Venge will clean up on those spiders. Big creep wave on the bottom lane. Who's going to kill us? I guess it's going to be Puck here. Going to luck out with EXP. And he's going to let them hit towers a little bit. I'm a little confused about this. I mean, I know there's a lot missing in action, but... Alright, so he will clean that up mostly. Sentinel team now defending mid. EXE's got to play this really safe. They want to win the game right here. Just get it over with. They just have to win one game, and they're going to be the champions. But MUFC going to do the similar. He does pick up an ultimate orb on OD, so his info levels are getting pretty good. Plus 63 here. Chen with the mech completed. Broodmother's still in the top lane. Always threatening to push. He's got his BKB finished. That means he may be able to pick off a solo Lion now. But Lion's actually in the mid lane, popping his bottle. His mana levels are very high, so that's good for him. He's going to be able to make a big impact on the team fight. 1800 gold on Enigma. Lion will take one rock. Power shot. Going to try to spot some heroes. Does hit OD, I think. And the tower will clear the creep wave. Nice. Picking off the two centaurs. This could be pretty big if they get these. Or at least one or two of them. That does pick off one centaur. So now Chen is going to be one creep less. So he's a little too nosy with his creeps there. And it looks like Breedmother on the top lane. Will he BKB? He will get it off. Epicenter completely wasted there. A little bit of a mistake by those two heroes. Did not quite have enough disable. And Breedmother very wisely. Definitely a good trade there. Pops his BKB, survives. And survives against a Sand King Lion who are trying to shut you down once again. And Breedmother is under farm. So we'll see what he goes for next. He's at 200 gold. Buy some TP scrolls. Burning ultis like that is never really a bad thing. It's only 100 second cooldown or 110 or something like that. So it's not the biggest loss ever for the Sand King, but... Did Lion pop his ulti? Yeah, Lion did not pop his ulti either, so... Alright, let's look at some CS totals while we're waiting. We may see a little bit of a skirmish in the bot lane, but it's just Puck versus NOD, and OD is leaving. So, CS totals, we have 100 on the Broodmother, 62 on Puck, 95 on the Windrunner. Any jungling, we have 79 jungle neutrals from the Enigma. And the rest of the Scourge team, 122 on the OD, 77 on Lion, 20 on Venge, 40 neutrals on Chen, and 71 neutrals on Sand King. So they're pretty equal here, not at a huge disadvantage here. Windrunner going to defend mid. Enigma does have his Blink Dagger, and he's very tanky with that Vanguard. His int gain is very good, up to 57 here. There's a little bit of initiation going on. Puck's actually going to get picked off. He does silence all these guys, but a little bit of a mistake from him. Really, really not having a good game. 0-5-5, he's got to be frustrated. He is literally the main reason that their score is so bad, but I don't completely blame him. I mean, once you get killed a couple times, he was fighting three good ganking heroes. And once you get picked off a couple times, you're in kind of a shitty situation. And I don't think he's going to buy back. What's his cooldown? 23 seconds till he gets back. And the Radiant team, or the Sentinel team, is going to have to maybe defend this. They're going to let the tower go. It's got 200 HP. It's not worth it. A ulti will come through. It's going to land right on the Ice Vortex. I like how he placed the Vortex in preparation. It's pretty cool stuff. But that was only a level 1 ulti, I think. Yeah, it didn't quite hit very hard. Level 9 on the AA. Does not produce quite as much as you would like. And OD getting a little bit of bonus damage from the Eidolons, plus 496. That's because his orb does do way more damage to bonus, or to illusions, or summoned units. Cool stuff, am I right? Ventral Spirit smoked up, looking for free wards. I think they will spot the Observer Ward on the high ground. It's a 80% ward, so man, I'm really surprised Vench hasn't died yet. Utilizing this gem very, very adequately, making sure that he doesn't die, keeps the gem alive. That is really important. Gotten a lot of value out of it so far, and it's really useful for ganking heroes like Broodmother. So, are we going to see an engagement? They do smoke up, but they're running into an entire group. Huge mistake here by EXE. They immediately lose the Enigma. Windrunner, will she drop as well? She does get swapped back, so that's it. Windrunner will die. I believe, almost guaranteed. Will they be able to disable on the Ancient Apparition? He's still trying to escape Vengeful Spirit. Will he outjuke him? It's daytime. I think he just ran into trouble. Does they have vision? I guess they don't have vision. And Puck actually goes in here. Maybe able to pick off Chen. Not going to happen. Puck goes down. And EXE in some trouble running uphill like that. That was a huge mistake. Like, literally, that was a huge mistake. Not just because it's like, oh yeah, he ran uphill into a bunch of heroes. That sucks. But basically for the reason that this got dewarded. And 30 seconds later, they think that they're going to smoke gank up the hill with three heroes. That's a big mistake, especially up against a big choke like this. Really, really was asking for trouble, and that's what they got. Enigma gets picked off immediately. Windrunner went down as well, I think. Maybe. Didn't quite catch that, but Puck died. Ancient Apparition survived, but huge mistake. Definitely not worth it. Three-man smoke checking your jungle after they just deward you. I mean, Vengeful Spirit was invisible. Maybe they just didn't realize that they weren't. Maybe they just thought maybe they're not in our jungle. But even still, it's a cocky, over dangerous move. Is basically what happened. Now Broodmother's still in the top lane. He's up to 2,200 gold now. OD as well, doing very good. Up to 2,000 gold. Possibly gonna finish a Django or something else. Probably gonna finish his Sheepstick, but he will have to sell an item. We'll see if he sells the bracer or the headdress. Bracer giving, actually headdress probably a little bit more useful. Only gives you, basically you get plus 1 stats and plus 3 damage. And actually plus 4 strength, plus 1 the other ones, whatever. But I would probably sell the Bracer myself. Lion is invisible here, he's level 16, he's going to initiate, he's going to go on the Broodmother. Will he be able to kill? I don't think he's going to. Actually, Venge is here as well, and there's the stun. Will he just ulti this? Black King bar is popped. He's going to try to TP out. Will he be able to make it? He gets swapped, though, by Vengeful Spirit. And that was a little bit of a mistake, once again, from Broodmother. He probably should have just ran. Popped the BKB and run. He forgot about Vengeful Swap, and Vengeful Swap did deny him from TPing out there, so he probably should have just tried to escape. I don't know if he would have been able to make it or not. I guess either way, he probably would have been swapped, but... yeah, Broodmother ends up dying once again. There's the A ulti. Is it going to land on the SK perfect ulti? But I think Sand King is going to be fine. He does have a Vanguard, so his HP levels are very good right now. Kind of an interesting pickup, going for the Vanguard after the Blink Dagger, just to give him more survivability. But MUFC in a really, really commanding position. 7-19, EXE most likely going to lose this game, kind of as a result of Broodmother dying way too much, and Fairy Dragon just not doing good enough either. He's up to 1,300 gold, so he's getting closer to the Blink Dagger, but... Orb is going to do a little bit of damage, does not hit Lion, barely dodges that with his Blink Dagger. And Chen, still with excellent creeps, man. One Dark Troll and two Centaurs. That is so useful, those stuns. If you can micro properly, Chen is such a powerful hero. More stun than anybody else. There's the smoke, though. Vengeful Spirit still has a freaking gem. I cannot believe he's got Power Treads now. He like had a gem before he had any other items. He was like Boots gem. And there's the swap. Gonna try to kill the Broodmother. There's the Hex as well. And gonna get a couple stuns. And that's it. Broodmother gets picked off again. Very, very good coordination from MUFC. They're playing so smart. Fairy Dragon a little far forward as well. Venge looking for a stun, but not going to get it. And there's the Arcane from the Chen. Will they be able to two-man defend this? The rest of EXE is on the way, though. Windrunner, no Force Staff yet. No Blink Dagger on Fairy Dragon. AA actually taking some disables. That's it for AA. Wow, big mistake from AA. Why was he up here? Did he get swapped or something? No, zero swap. Huge mistake from Ancient Apparition. It's a Shacklishon and Sand King, but that's it. EXE keeps making mistakes like this, and that's a huge that's like giant mistakes after giant mistakes. Ancient Apparition doesn't need to hug the tower right here. Well, Puck actually is going to ulti that. Tries to catch a hero, but not going to get him. And Ventral Spirit once again going to do some dewarding, but little does he know, EXE doesn't have anything up. Now Sand King with a Ring of Health. Apparently doesn't have enough regen, I guess. He's not very concerned about an Aghanim Scepter, which isn't the worst thing in the world. Against heroes like this, I guess you're probably a little more concerned about HP. I think is pretty smart. I mean, Puck can avoid the damage. Broodmother can avoid the damage to Black King Bar. Windrunner can just run away, I guess. But I'm not really sure what he's going to use that Ring of Health for. Maybe a Pipe? I'm going to guess a Pipe. Vanguard Pipe on Sand King. Playing kind of like a gank teamfight support role. And what does OD have? He does have his Ginsu. He did finish his Ginsu. Will he initiate? He's looking about it. He's in Viz. There's Vision. They know. There's the silence. He does go on the Enigma, but he's not hitting nearly as hard as he wanted to. And wow, takes a lot of damage before he four staffs away. Broodmother immediately stunned by the Sand King, and there's the ulti, 870 damage done to the Broodmother, but he is healing this back up, still hasn't popped his BKB, just now popped, and will he be able to pick off the Sand King? It's going to be close, he's not quite doing enough damage, he's huge creep block, and that's it, Sand King going to survive. Unfortunately for MUFC, they send back him. I think he was going to be able to survive. There's the stun now on Broodmother, a couple nukes, will they be able to pick him off with one hit, down to 20 HP, Enigma goes in, does the Midnight Pulse, he does get stunned by Sand King, and that may be it for Enigma, but absolutely saves that Broodmother there from dying. And that's it. EXE calling good game. We're going to the next game, guys. It is 2-1. Why are we saying... Oh, okay. And game leaves. So I think we must have gotten a lead for the last game or something like that. And we're going to drop out of the game, so... Alright, guys. Be right back with game 4 of this best of 5. We're on to game 4. Game 4 here coming up. EXE MUFC versus EXE game 3. Awesome game. All right, guys, stay tuned. We'll be back with game 3 in just a second for the finals of the Rokkat Gosu Cup number 4.